Welcome to the Insights Hub Dashboard Designer video series, where we will give you a detailed overview of the application and equip you with all the needed information to start your journey with Insights Hub Dashboard Designer. In this video, you'll see how Apache ECharts can be included into your personalized dashboards. With the integration of Apache ECharts, you get more options to create advanced visualizations in Dashboard Designer. Apache ECharts are a powerful, interactive and open-source charting and visualization library based on JavaScript and TypeScript code. There are multiple examples for different charts on the Apache ECharts homepage. With version 10 of the Dashboard Designer, it is possible to integrate these charts into your created dashboard. By adding JavaScript code, you can personalize your widgets so that the visualization is adapted to your data. This leads to a better understanding of the processes in a production facility where the data is provided. Let's start by adding an Apache ECharts widget in a Dashboard Designer dashboard. We begin at the Apache ECharts website to choose the right template. Therefore, choose the Examples tab in the upper menu. On the website, the diagrams are sorted according to the different chart types. In addition to common types like line, bar, or pie charts, there are also advanced diagrams for visualizing data. For example, in a radar or sunburst chart. In this video, we want to focus on implementing a radar widget. For that, let's have a look at the basic radar chart example of Apache ECharts. On the left, you can see the necessary JavaScript and TypeScript code. On the right, you get an insight into what the chart will look like. Now, the integration of the selected diagram should be started. Therefore, we open the Dashboard Designer application in the Insights Hub Launchpad. Afterwards, select your dashboard, which should be extended by an Apache ECharts widget. If you haven't created a dashboard so far, create a new one by clicking on the New button in the top right corner. Next, we copy the Apache ECharts JavaScript code from the website and enter it in an empty Apache ECharts widget in the Insights Hub Dashboard Designer by adding a widget, as we did in other videos. In the Change Visualization drop-down menu, select the last item called Business Charts. Subsequently, you will see a place where you can enter code. It is displayed in the lower right corner of your screen where JavaScript code creates a time series chart while using the Apache ECharts functionality. You can delete this code and insert the basic radar chart code of the Apache ECharts website. To run this example radar chart, you must replace the characters option equals. Please enter instead the keyword return. Now the chart will be displayed if you once click in the widget preview section in the middle of your screen. As you can see in the diagram, the chart is very useful to represent multidimensional data structures. To point out a comparison of two equal data structures, it is common to use such a radar chart. Next, we add your own data to the chart. Starting point is to select the desired asset and its associated aspect. Also, choosing the right variables is a step that should not be forgotten. To realize this, we created a new asset structure where two equal production lines in different plants can be compared. Since two different asset structures need to be compared, we must add a second query in the query section located in the lower left corner. As you can see, one query is selected for a plant in Munich, while another corresponds to a facility in London. Proceeding onward by inserting a new code block above the whole return section. After setting the data query, you can call up your data using the following code. To get a better understanding of called up data, you can open the console of the developer section of your browser. To demonstrate that, we insert a console.log data command above the data query code block. If the console of the developer is now opened, the desired data will be displayed. To use the whole amount of data, we add further data queries for all variables. The indexes of the field sub-items must be adapted to the individual data structure. The specific indices to be used can be identified through the browser console. In this data structure, data points 3 and 4 are defined with the data type integer. Consequently, rounding them to 2 decimal places is not meaningful. Now the indicator's code block should be adapted. We enter here the variable names and the possible max value for each variable. The number of used variables and indicators could be individually customized and depends on your own use case. In the final step of creation of this widget, we add the specific data streams to the JavaScript code block copied from the Apache ECharts website. For that, the series section is predefined. In the data query, which was implemented shortly before, we get a whole array structure for each variable back. In a radar chart, only specific values, such as the most recent values or the average of an array, are displayed. In this instance, we aim to visualize only the most recent values from the various arrays. To achieve this, you can utilize the predefined JavaScript pop function, which extracts the last value from each array. Once you incorporate this function into your code, it will appear as follows. Finally, you can change the title of the diagram or the desired legends on your own. Afterwards, your first radar chart is ready for use. To switch back to the overall dashboard, click the Apply button in the upper right corner. In this demo case, the chart looks like this. To sum up, by using Apache ECharts, it is possible for dashboard users to work with extensively customized charts with very little effort for the dashboard developer. In particular, the high degree of flexibility of the charts leads to significant time savings. For more information, find further links, other videos, and the technical documentation in the description below.